हेलो एंड वेलकम फ्रेंड्स. इन दिस पर्टिकुलर मॉड्यूल आई विश टू डिस्कस अबाउट जनरल कंसिडरेशंस फॉर म्युनिसिपल सॉलिड वेस्ट कलेक्शन. वील डिस्कस अबाउट ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ सॉलिड वेस्ट कलेक्शन, फैक्टर्स टू इंक्लूड, टूल्स फॉर कलेक्शन, components of collection, present collection scenario for Indian circumstances, provisions for the collection in MSW rules 2016, elements of waste collection for high rise buildings and automated pneumatic solid waste collection system. As you learn the content, you will be able to state objectives and factors affecting collection of municipal solid waste, tools and vehicles employed for solid waste collection, present collection scenario and practices, and major provisions in MSW 2016. So far, after discussing these functional elements of municipal solid waste management, we had very detailed discussion about first two elements in last two presentations that are related with this waste generation, and secondly, handling of the waste on site, its separation, on site storage, and the processing alternatives that are available at the point of generation. So, these particular first two blocks, as you know, are associated with generator actually, whereas this block onwards, now the waste will be in the hands of urban local body or its representative, and hence now this particular point onwards we can think of different alternatives. After this particular collection, waste may lead to transfer and transport facility. If there is no transfer and transport facility, and if no other treatment option is expected, it may directly lead to this disposal, or otherwise it may also lead to separation, processing and transformation facility meant for that particular municipal solid waste. Hence, this particular collection element serves as junction kind of thing. For this particular waste collection, we mainly deal with two objectives. The first one, that waste generated from this particular source is collected regularly and it won't be lingering on the streets. Also, this collection mechanism will be in good synchronization with the on-site storage facilities. So, under this particular collection element, we wish to address these particular factors: collection frequency, tools and vehicles, collection services at the point of collection, labor requirement, type of container collection, route selection, and transportation. as we refer to this particular functional element and literature related with that, you will find two distinguished terms. One is primary collection and second one is secondary collection. Under this particular primary collection, we wish to have that waste to be collected, lifted, and removal of this particular segregated solid waste from the point of generation. Whereas, through this particular secondary collection, we wish to have this particular waste collection from its point of deposition at secondary storage depot or bins for its onward transportation for the transparent transport, disposal or separation. So in between these two blocks, here what we have is primary. This block onwards, what we have is nothing but secondary. So the first factor we will discuss in detail. Here, under this particular collection frequency, again we have to consider the number of factors. Say for example, the first factor is type of source. So depending on the source, whether it is residential, commercial, institutional, etc., the nature of the waste will change. Its quantity will change, its characteristics will change. People's awareness as well as their behavioral patterns will change. And hence, this is one of the factors to be taken into account while deciding the collection frequency. In order to have that particular secondary collection facilitated, we have to think about the accessibility at that particular collection beam for the collection vehicle. So whether the houses are squatter one, whether there are detached bungalows, whether there are high-rise structures, whether there is a complex of apartments, so depending on such factors, the collection frequency will change. Within that particular complexes, the availability of the space, the size and type of storage facility, whether it is small, large, individual or communal, it will also ask for different collection frequencies. If the waste generation is high, if the rate of generation is high, naturally, the collection frequency will be small. Also, as we consider the characteristic of the waste, see, if the waste that we are dealing with is biodegradable in nature, in order to avoid the further influences associated with decomposed waste, it's better to have the waste collected frequently. Climatic conditions is one of the important factors which we haven't considered so far. Here, as we deal with summer, as we deal with winter, as we deal with rainy season, each of the seasons will dictate certain terms as far as collection frequency is concerned. Just I have considered three examples here. The way you see here, the snowfall is covering all that particular waste bins. The approach is covered by that particular snowfall. So under such circumstances, the collection of that particular municipal solid waste is not possible at all. Further, it will get weight. It could be compacted. There would be change in the density. Accordingly, the handling of such thrust will be highly difficult. As we consider the rainy season, the west, which is light in nature, will travel with the storm runoff, and the low-lying areas will be getting filled. Even the thrown garbage or the waste accumulated over the communal bins, as it comes across the storm runoff, it will leach away certain harmful content which may join the nearby gutters, and it may join further the water bodies in order to cause the pollutions. Even during the summer, the fires could be more frequent. As well, the high winds may litter the west, making it difficult to collect. Hence, these climatic conditions is one of the factors asking for this particular collection frequency. If the population density is high, naturally the waste generation will be high. And hence, the waste collection needs to be done frequently. Some complexes, the way we discussed previously, say, for example, if the area is more than 5,000 square meter, they could be having their own treatment setups. Even because of the awareness of the people, the reuse could be good, recyclability could be good, the biodegradable waste could have been subjected for composting. So, as this particular factor affects the generation and its storage requirement directly, accordingly, it will hamper this particular collection frequency. The next factor that we wish to discuss is about these particular tools for primary and secondary collection. The collection is such an element which involves a lot many tools. There could be vehicles, there could be certain hand tools, even it could be attracting the costs associated with that. So, these particular tools, the way I have tried to present here, it could be hand driven, it could be mechanically driven, it could also be animal driven, it could be roll drop trucks, it could be fore and aft tippers, it could be driven by tractors, they could be provided with compactor mechanisms, they could be tipping type, sometimes they could be lifted up from front, side, as well as even the rear. So, these particular primary and secondary collections will be involving lot many containerized hand carts, motorized vehicles, as well as certain tricycles. As the waste collection occurs and proceeds from point to point. Here the way you see, in the primary waste collection, the way we discussed previously, we wish to have this particular waste transported to communal bin through the generator only. This particular point onwards, we'll be discussing about this particular secondary collection, in which now the waste will be passed from that particular community bin to truck, From where it will lead to transfer station, or it may lead to disposal, or it may lead to processing center, or it may lead directly to this particular disposal facility, the way here just we have considered its flow. So as we are involving such number of vehicles, number of hand tools, number of crew, and cost associated with the fuel, salary, maintenance, as well as this particular picking up the solid waste, transporting it, this is the costliest element as far as municipal solid waste management is concerned. You can have the better feel of the collection vehicles on this particular slide. So sometimes even the collection could be automated, or also it could be split body type. The way we discussed about certain huge establishment, commercial establishments, or certain squatter buildings, slum areas, wherein we'll be providing certain common container. So at that time, this particular tilt frame loader could be very convenient. If the areas are enclosed, if we wish to have the uniform nature waste collection, this particular vacuum collection, as you see here, could also be useful. Sometimes, employing this particular recyclable collector from block to block, from door to door, or with some common predefined place, it could be processing center, it could be disposal facility, it could be transfer station, this recyclable collector could also be very helpful. Broadly, these particular waste collection components can be considered under these particular three heads. The first one is collection services, in which we can discuss about various types and methods. So these particular collection services could be considered under these particular different heads. Again, let me share one word with you. From the place to place, from the literature to literature, this particular collection services could have been expressed with slightly different words. So this door-to-door collection, block collection, backyard collection, alley collection, curbside collection, community bin collection, communal system collection. Here, it's better to understand the point of generation, from where the waste is expected to be collected as far as this particular providing services are concerned. As you see here about this particular communal system, it is the end point of the primary collection, and it is also the initiation of secondary collection. Here, these containers and collection bins could be of varied types. It could be having different capacities, and it could also be governed by different agencies. But here, there is not much control as far as the waste transfer is concerned. As you see here, this is some place of community bin, wherein the nearby habitat is expected to pass on their particular waste so that the representative of urban local body will be collecting the waste from that point for its westward journey. As far as these particular communal systems are concerned, there are many issues. The way you see here, this is curbside system. Here, the generator is expected to place the waste through designated containers along the curve. So accordingly, here there could be certain, say, color coding systems, they could be using certain designated containers, they could be using certain different varied capacity of these particular containers. And as the vehicle collects such kind of the waste, automated collection is possible. So as they empty it down and they place this particular container along the curve side, the generator will take away that particular container to their respective places. The similar kind of this particular waste handover may occur along this particular backyard. Presently, this particular backyard or this particular alley system is mostly obsolete for certain old typical layouts. There is a provision of such alleys as well as backyards in order to have these particular waste management practices executed. But as far as the modern city layouts are concerned, could be because of the least preference to the waste management and the cost of the land, the approaches in the form of alleys and these particular backyards is not observed to much of its extent. However, block to block, door to door collection is possible. So here the collection crew go along door to door with the collection vehicle. So the way you see here, this is the front of a particular house. So as the waste collecting vehicle approaches this, it will be collecting this particular waste, or the people who are residing by, they would be depositing, handing over their waste in such kind of a system. So such services could be provided by that particular municipality itself, or otherwise there could be certain private firm who could be working on behalf of that particular municipality. Sometimes for a given complex, the private residents could have appointed a private agency to collect their particular waste, process their particular waste, and then hand it over to the private body or the agency working through this particular municipality or urban local body. Depending on the kind of the service and depending on who is providing that particular service, there will be change in the vehicle and labor requirement. So as you see through these couple of slides, you know that it involves lot many tools and variety of the vehicles, and even the crew may change at different stages. Some of the factors that we have to take into account while deciding this vehicle and labor requirements are, mostly these particular laborers who are working for that particular waste collections are not fully trained. Many times they are unaware about the associated health hazards. If the route collection, deposition, and if the communications are not proper, there could be lack of coordination and overlapping of the responsibilities. The vehicle selection, whether to go for hand-driven crop, whether to go for certain, say, tricycle, whether to go for door-to-door collection vehicle, and such things. So it needs certain scientific as well as some statistics based on which the collection route and vehicles can be optimized. It is quite probable that the collection vehicles may not be sufficient as far as their travel is concerned. There could be some limitations associated with the local topography. There could be traffic congestion issues. Also, there could be inadequate transfer points, and many times one of the major issues is lack of fund and the effective utilization of the fund. Because of many such reasons, the concerned department who is dealing with that particular solid waste management may deploy old vehicles, and deploying these particular old vehicles would attract the noise pollution, leakage of the moisture leaking through the moist waste, and associated maintenance. Also, for a given region, one may go for hauled container systems, stationary container systems, or combination of that. We will discuss about this hauled container system and stationary container system in our subsequent presentation. As you see, that particular collection services, just the way we considered communal, block, curbside, door to door. So please mind here, this is indicating the point of collection. Just I wanted to focus on the two things. Here, as we wish to have certain things recycled, reused, this communal bin is one of the better options, which is more susceptible for these particular scavenging operations. Whereas, if as the vehicle travels door to door, block to block, the scavenging operation is not possible at all. The way we considered about this particular curb type services, as the generator keeps their waste bin along the curbs for the collection, so formally, informally, this particular scavenging is possible. The cost of this particular collection and the level of this particular services will be varied as we go for each of these particular services. So the way we consider about that particular, say, first communal bin, as you considered in this particular picture, satisfying any of the element around such kind of the communal bin is not possible at all. Here, nobody is the owner of this particular kind of place. Hence, the way I try to say, the level of satisfaction will be very low, it will be very poor. Here, one is expected to have bulk of the waste collected at a point. Hence, the vehicle collection at a stage with more capacity, with low size of crew is possible. Here, as you see, for each of these particular points, the vehicle has to move, stop and pick up even for smaller capacity. That means, as compared to such kind of the options, this would be low in cost as far as collection is concerned. But as we consider in that pictures, curbside or door to door will be providing good services at the time, even the cost will also be high. As far as Indian circumstances are concerned, this block type of collection service does not exist at all. Let's consider about some facts. According to this particular 2020 report, that way it's recent, there is a generation of this particular 62 million tons per year. By 2030, it will reach to 165 million tons. Presently, 43 million tons is being collected per year. Out of this, the way you see, 31 million ton goes to the landfill sites, whereas around 12 million tons it is treated. So, as compared to this particular 62 million tons of generation, nearly half of it is being dumped, whereas just 1/5 of it is being treated. In light of implementation of very ambitious government schemes like Swachh Bharat Mission and number of schemes the way I have discussed in earlier presentations, the scenario is very pathetic and needs immediate consideration. Around 60 to 80% of total budgetary cost are associated with simply collection. So for a given place, we can think of various performance indicators showing how that particular collection practices are taking place for a given region. One can think of provision of the budgets, expenditure made on the operational activities, the haul distances, the number of containers and quantity of the waste being collected, schedule and routing of the vehicles, number of waste truck trips, the kind of the infrastructure that is available, the penalty being charged, and labor hours spent. Mostly, for Indian circumstances and as far as the literature is concerned, it is also true for other developing nations. The system is labor and capital intensive. It makes the situation further difficult because of the poor building layouts, road congestions, moisture content that is available within the west, associated transportation costs, creation of the physical infrastructure. Central government may be providing huge financial support in order to create that, but operation and maintenance is really an issue. Because of this particular moisture, because of the unhealthy content of that municipal solid waste, the containers are leaky, mostly damaged. The last point is one of the important factors to deal with, especially for the apartments. Again, the question arises about the ownership of a point. There will be a number of the flats who will be sending their particular waste at the communal bin. So control is impossible. Same thing is true at the market. In Maharashtra, as well as similar states in India, usually every day is bazaar day. So small vendors who will be selling variety of the commodities, right from vegetables to grains and even the textiles, footwears and so many such things, eatables, they will be paying certain small amount to the local urban local body in order to occupy the space, in order to take care of the waste being generated. But at the end of the day, the kind of the waste being thrown will be such varied, and next day number of laborers will be required in order to manage that particular waste is a situation for every day for all the regions. As far as these 2016 rules are concerned, some of the major points associated with this collection can be just attended. They have given some special directive related with the collection and disposal of this particular sanitary waste. Before throwing any kind of this particular sanitary waste, the manufacturers or the brand owners are expected to enhance the awareness of the users and provide some pouches, wrappers, so that the user will wrap it. It will be marking that kind of the package, the pouch, with certain red mark, and then it will be thrown in the waste stream of non-biodegradable waste. Also, as we consider a certain kind of the packaging waste, the manufacturer is expected to have that particular packaging waste recollected either through them or developing certain system so that this particular consumer will return that kind of the packaging material to the agency working on behalf of this particular producer or marketeer, so that the packaging waste won't be transformed into the waste, but it could be subjected to reuse and recycle. As one of the provisions, the urban local bodies can decide the user fees for the collection. So depending on the area, one can decide this particular collection price. It will be variable according to the kind of generator. Also, if the generator is not following his responsibility, there is a provision of spot fine for littering and non-segregation of the waste. The rules tell us about the inclusion of the informal sector of rag pickers, waste pickers and kabadiwalas into the formal sector. Also, the rules stipulates zero tolerance for throwing, burning and burying of the solid waste on streets, open public spaces, and especially these particular water drains. As you see here, the burning of the waste is major cause of smoke and particulate, which affects the visibility in that particular area. The blocking of the drains and hence flooding of the nearby area cause the life of these nearby poor people highly unacceptable. As we speak about certain multi-storied buildings, the kind of system adopted for solid waste collection in developed countries and some developed residential complexes. Here, the waste is collected through certain vertical piping system, wherein a certain user from certain level dumps its waste in this trash chute by making use of this user panel interface. So it has the provision of wet waste, dry waste, recyclables and such things, from where it moves through the divergent traps and ends into collection chamber, where the dry waste and wet waste is collected separately, from where it will be removed with certain frequency. Intermediately, there could be generation of some obnoxious gases as well as smell, and in order to have that removed, some vents are provided at the top. also for developed regions, such chutes provided for that particular solid waste collection could also be further connected to underground pipe network, very similar to sewerage network, leading to central waste handling facility. So there is an involvement of this particular vertical shaft, discharge valves, air intakes, discharging valves meant for the waste to join these discharge valve chambers. There could be certain loading stations at various open places as well as certain designated points from where the waste will be traveling to the waste handling facility. This particular system utilizes this underground pipe network to transport this particular solid waste. It also directly encourages the recycling, making this particular waste segregation handling easier. There are a number of advantages. Storage space is compromised. Odor generation will be less. Vehicle need not travel along the roads, hence there will be reduction in the traffic. The emissions of that particular waste is avoided. Burning is avoided. Hence, it would be having lower carbon footprint. There is not direct exposure of that particular waste to animal, rodents, etc. That's why it is pest free. System won't be noisy. The systems are sealed. Here, that vertical shaft as well as entire the pipe network would be sealed. Hence, the primary collection point would be this one. Secondary collection onward will be totally mechanized. Hence, labor requirements are less, as direct exposure with the waste is avoided. There won't be question of this particular occupancy hazards. The waste coming through the various streams from various loading stations can be subjected to recycling directly. However, as we consider adopting such a kind of the system for the varied kind of the waste, which is not segregated at all, initial cost would be high, operation cost will be high, maintenance cost will also be high. However, as we think of certain areas which are observing proper discipline, which are properly mechanized, the people who are using that particular area are well aware of the cost and the effects associated with the waste management. For such people, for such regions, such waste collection system will be very good alternative. So, thanks for your attention. I hope the general consideration that we discussed about this particular municipal solid waste collection are clear to you. As one of the systems that is adopted for the waste collection. That is haul container system we'll discuss in our subsequent presentation. So bye till then. I wish you very happy learning. Thank you.